Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to another Photoshop tutorial. In this video, I want to show you how to enhance or even add a little bit of artificial fog to your images. If you want to follow along, you can find the raw file in the description of this video. Keep in mind, this is not only doable in the Camera Raw Editor, but also in Adobe Lightroom if you are using this software instead. So let's go. Here we are in the Camera Raw Editor. To add fog to an image, I'm using local adjustments. However, before I can add effects like this, I'm always going through the basic stuff first. So if you're just here for the fog part, feel free to check the chapters of the video. Now let's get the basic stuff right. First off, I want this image to be saturated, so I'm going to change the profile to Adobe Landscape. Nice, then let's go through the basic stuff. For the white balance, I'm going with daylight. Not much changing here, but I like the look of it. Now I do want to bring the highlights down slightly. And I also want to bring the shadows down to get some more contrast. Just like that. And let's boost the whites. Nice. Now I do think I need to crop this image just a little bit. I want to keep that island in the middle part centered. So this looks pretty good. Finally, I do want to add a little bit of vibrance, because as I said, I want this image to be saturated. Just like that. Now that we have the base stuff done, we can check out the local adjustments and thus add the fog. You can see I'm using the newest version of Photoshop, so the local adjustments do look a little bit different here. And as I said, I'm going to use radial gradients to add the fog. So let me click on this right here, and then I'm just creating a new radial filter right there. And I'm going to place it just over the water surface in the background, because that is an area where natural fog would actually appear. And it's very important to keep this radial filter rather thin. So it doesn't make sense to make it really thick like this, but just keep it small and simple. And place it above the water surface. Now with this out of the way, you can see I also have increased the theta all the way up. And now let's simply go to the effects tab down there and drop the dehaze. You can see this works really, really good. But also this makes the area in the back a lot brighter, which looks a bit unnatural. But in this case, we can counter that by dropping the whites as well. So if you want to push the fog a little further, you can also decrease the contrast, which helps as well. And now, with the effect actually visible, you can still drag around this radial filter and just position it right. So I think this looks pretty good. And once we're done here, I can go in the mask menu, click on those three buttons and just say duplicate the mask one. And I'm going to position this one on the other side. Since we are kind of nearer to the foreground with this radial filter, I can actually make it a little bigger, but just a bit, not too much. So I think this might actually be a bit too dark, so I'm going to introduce some more whites back to this radial filter. All right, and let's also add some contrast back. I don't want to lose too much detail in the forest in the back there, but this looks pretty good. We could play around with the dehaze some more. All right. Now let's create another mask. For this, I'm just pressing the J key to bring up a new radial filter. And then I'm creating another thinner radial filter just for the foreground here. And again, I'm going to work with negative dehaze to add just a little bit of fog. And again, I'm going to drop the contrast as well. Just like that. And I could even increase the blacks, which helps for the artificial fog. Of course, I want to keep detail in this area, so I'm not overdoing it, which is really, really hard. Let's find the right spot. But this looks pretty good. All right. Now that is without all those adjustments, and here we have the image with the added fog. Of course, that is a very, very subtle effect, But of course you could also go really crazy and, let's say, decrease the dehaze for the overall image and thus create a more heavy fog effect if you want. But for this image, the more subtle version is looking a lot better to me. Now that we have the fog right in this image, I guess that's pretty much it for the tutorial. Still, I want to keep showing you the post-processing for the rest of the image. So we can use a few other local adjustments. In this case, I do want to create a linear gradient and therefore I'm pushing the G key. And now let's just add one for the foreground, just like that. Here I do want to make the reflection a little more interesting by bringing up the clarity. And also it appears to be a bit dark, so I'm going to increase the whites just a bit. All right. Now I do want to make the blue part of the sky behind the clouds darker. With the newest Photoshop update, this workflow has changed a little bit. This means I'm going to create a new mask and here I'm going to select the color range. With this mask active, I'm going to click in the blue part of the sky which I want to change, just like that. And maybe let's pick another color tone by holding down the shift key, like this, and maybe right there. Now we have selected all those blue color tones in the whole image, but of course we don't want to change the foreground, so we need to subtract this from our mask. So on the subtract button I'm going to create a linear gradient and just create one going up like this. So let me show you the overlay so you can see what actually is selected by this mask we just created. And you can see we have a pretty good sky selection. So then let's bring down the exposure and thus we can add some really nice contrast here. Perfect. Then I guess that's it for the local adjustments. As I said, I don't want to overdo it. So let's go right ahead to the color grading. In the color mixer, I do want to boost the orange tones and the yellow tones. And while we're here, I'm going to slightly drop the blue tones since they are quite heavy. In the luminance tab, we could make the sky even darker by bringing down the blue luminance. Awesome. Maybe a bit too much. That's better. Then I am checking the color grading real quick. I'm not sure if I want to change anything. But I might change the midtones by adding a warm tone to them. Just a slight orange tone with very low saturation. All right. Then the last part of the color grading is in the calibration tab, where I'm going to drop the blue primary hue. And I'm boosting the saturation at the same time. This will just make those autumn colors look a little better. All right, perfect. Then we could sharpen this image. And now let's open this up in Photoshop to finish the editing. Now, first off, let me clean up this image. Therefore, I'm going to use the spot healing brush, zoom in a bit, and then I'm just brushing over stuff which I want to remove. As you can see, this works pretty good. And I'm just trying to make the reflection a little more clean. I'm also doing the same thing on this bush on the right side. Just roughly painting over it should be good enough. All right, perfect. Now I'm going to take a closer look at the histogram. I do think we can add a little bit more contrast. And when taking a closer look at the histogram, you can see there's a huge chunk of dark tones missing from this image. So let's just create a levels adjustment layer. And again, you can see the histogram here. Now, if I bring up this point, we will get a lot more contrast for this image. So this looks pretty good, but I do want to mask out a few areas of this adjustment layer, especially for the foggy area. So I'm just using a black brush and painting over this levels adjustment layer to bring back fog. Just like that. Then let's merge those two real quick. And finally, I do want to check the Nick Collection plugin. With this plugin, I do want to use the polarization effect. As you can see, this will make the colors a lot stronger, which I quite like. So this looks pretty cool. Let's apply it right away. And here we have the finished image. So I hope this tutorial was helpful and interesting. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments. And thank you so much for watching this video.